Mayta, you smell with your nose, and you hear with your ears, and you see with your eyes. Oh, hi. My name is B, like the letter B. This is Mr. Butterfly. And this is Mayta, the brown bear. Today, we are learning about our five senses. Do you know what your five senses are? Well, let me tell you. Our five senses are sight, hearing, smell, touch, and taste.
Woo!
To recap, our five senses are number one, sight. We use our eyes to see. Number two, hearing. We use our ears to hear. Number three, smell. We use our nose to smell. Number four, touch. We use our hands to feel. Number five, taste. We use our tongue to taste.
Woo!
Now, I'm going to show you an activity that requires us to use all of our five senses. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Yes? Okay, let's do it. Whoa, Mayta! It's a popcorn machine! Whoa!
Mm-hmm.
We are going to make some popcorn. Now, see if you can notice us using each one of our five senses as we do this activity. Okay, let's make some popcorn! I've already added some corn kernels and some buttery oil in here. All I have to do is push the start button on the side of the machine right here. Okay, are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Let's do it. Look at that, Mayta. Look at the top. Mayta, do you see the kernels popping into fluffy popcorn? Yes! I do too! Wow! Do you hear the popping sound the kernels make when they burst? Mayta, do you smell the sweet smell of buttery popcorn?
Mm-hmm.
Yes? So do I. It smells delicious.
Whoa.
Wow, Mayta. Look at all that popcorn popping. Popcorn is done popping. So far, we have used three of our five senses. Mayta, would you like to eat some popcorn?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Okay, I'll take this little bowl right here. Oh, Mayta, I just used my hands to touch the popcorn. The popcorn feels very soft. Now, let's eat some popcorn. Here you go, Mayta. There you go. Oh, isn't that delicious? Okay, I'm going to try. Do you know what scents we just used? Oh, that's right. we used our tongues to taste the delicious popcorn. Wow! Let's recap. Mayta and I used our eyes to see the popcorn popping. We used our ears to hear the popcorn popping. We used our noses to smell the popcorn. We used our hands to touch the popcorn. And we used our tongues to taste the popcorn. We used all of our five senses. Whoa! What's that?
Mm.
Oh, Mayta has a question.
Mm-hmm.
Why do we taste different flavors when we eat or drink? Oh, that is a good question. Oh, that's Miss Y calling. Hi, Miss Y.
Hi, B. Do you and Mayta have a question for me?
Well, yes, we do. Why do we taste different flavors when we eat or drink?
Oh, that is a great question. I'll set up an interesting taste experiment to show Mayta when he visits the Curiosity Lab today. Bye for now.
Bye, Miss Y. Miss Y is our friend. She is a scientist who works at the Curiosity Lab in the city. Hey, Mayta, are you ready to go visit Miss Y at the Curiosity Lab?
Mm-hmm.
Yes? Okay, have a wonderful time, Mayta.
Hi, Mayta. It is so wonderful to see you.
Mm-hmm. Okay, you asked me, why do we taste different flavors when we eat or drink? By the way, the word flavor means the special or unique taste of a food or drink. Well, we taste different flavors because we have thousands and thousands of tiny little taste buds on our tongue. These buds are tiny bumps. I'll show you. This is Bolty the robot. Bolty, can you bring up a picture of the human mouth? We have to zoom in so we can see the tiny taste buds on this tongue. Look at all those taste buds. Thank you, Bolty. Mayta, do you know what a taste bud's job is? Do you? Taste buds have itty-bitty hairs that send messages to our brains when we eat or drink. These messages tell our brains if a food or drink is sweet, salty, sour, bitter, or umami. Umami means flavors like broth or cooked meat, like a steak or a hamburger. Did you know that your sense of smell also helps you taste food and drinks by smelling them first? Your nose can smell over 10,000 different scents. When a smell lands inside your nose, it starts a chemical change that sends a smell signal to your brain, telling you what your food or drink is going to taste like before you taste it. This process continues as you chew and swallow your food. Now get this. We also use our sense of sight to help taste food. When you see a food, your brain tells you what it is going to taste like before you taste it. An example would be if you see a strawberry on your plate, you know it's a strawberry without smelling or tasting it. So, three of our five senses, smell, sight, and taste, work together to help us taste different flavors. Mayta, I'm going to do a taste experiment to show you how our sight, smell, and taste all work together. I am going to wear this nose plug to take away my sense of smell, and I'm going to close my eyes to take away my sense of sight. Closing my eyes and wearing this nose plug means I can only taste with my tongue. You taste a lot less when you are not using your sense of smell or your sense of sight. Bolty, after I close my eyes, please place three different drinks in front of me. Then I will taste each drink to see if I can guess what it is without using my sense of smell or using my sense of sight. Mayta, are you ready to see what happens when I take away my sense of smell and my sense of sight? Okay, putting on my nose plug now. Oh, I can't smell anything. And if I close my eyes, well, I can't see anything either.
Okay, Bolty. Use your magic and place my three drinks. Remember, I cannot see or smell anything. All I can do is taste with my tongue and my taste buds. Okay, let's try the first drink. Wow. I can't taste any flavors, Mayta. I don't taste anything. Okay, let's try the second drink. Found it. Okay, this is an interesting experiment. Okay, second drink. Wow. Again, Mayta. I don't actually taste any flavors in that second drink either. Okay, let's see this third drink. Excuse me, Mayta. I can feel your fuzzy sweater. Okay, here we go. Third and final drink. Wild. Wild, I can't taste anything. Okay. So now that I've tried all three drinks, I'm going to open my eyes, take off this nose plug to see what my three drinks are. Oh my goodness. Apple juice, milk, and lemon juice. Without my sense of smell and sense of sight, Mayta, I could not taste the different flavors of these three drinks. The experiment we just did shows us how our senses work together. We really use our sense of taste, our sense of sight, and our sense of smell to taste food and drinks. Mayta, thank you for visiting the Curiosity Lab today. And remember, Miss Y is here, so ask away.
Did you have a good time with Miss Y learning why we can taste so many different flavors? Yes? Hey, Mayta, do you know what time it is? It's time to dance. This is where we stop what we are doing, stand up, and dance. You can do whatever dance move you feel like doing. Do you hear that? It's the idea train! And look! It's Pinky the Boombox! Hi, Pinky the Boombox! Okay. Thank you, idea train! All right. We will put Pinky the Boombox right here. Pinky plays our music. I'm going to take this gold cassette tape and put it in here, then I'll close it up, and I'll push the button with the triangle on it, the play button. Are you ready to dance? Yes? Okay, I'm going to push the play button now. Okay, let's get back to what we were doing. Guess what? It's time to share some Mayta art! Are you ready for our first piece of art? Yes? Okay. This art was sent to us by a family who lives in Kansas. A really awesome kid named Felix made this Mayta art. Whoa! Hey, Mayta, Look at you right in the center of this piece of art. Oh, and look, there's the idea train and Pinky the boombox. And Mayta, look, it's me, B, right over here. And Mayta, it's your favorite stuffy, Mimi the orange fox. Woo! Felix, thank you for sending us this magnificent Mayta art. Okay. Are you ready for another piece of art? Yes! All right. This art was sent to us by a family who lives in Hong Kong. A cool kid named Charlie made this Mayta art. Whoa! Mm. Hey, look, Mayta, there you are. Oh, and look, it's me, B. Whoa, I love your trees, Charlie. And I love that you wrote Mayta's name. M-A-Y-T-A, Mayta. Charlie, thank you for sending us this fantastic Mayta art. Okay, and our last piece of art we're going to share today is from a family who lives in Canada. Whoa! Two brothers, Oliver and Milo, made this Mayta art. Whoa! Hey, look! There you are, Mayta, right there. Milo drew you right there. And Oliver drew you right here. Whoa! Oh, and look, Mr. Butterfly and me, B. I really like how you drew my idea hat on B's head. Oh, and look, the idea train. Wow! Oliver and Milo, thank you so much for sending us this awesome Mayta. Before we go, let's say five good things about ourselves. Do you want to do that? Yes? Okay, I'll go first, and then you repeat what I say after me. Number one, I am strong. Number two, I am helpful. Number three, I am smart. Number four, I am brave. Number five, I am kind. That was great. Thank you for spending your time with Mayta and myself and learning about the five senses. Mm-hmm. Until next time, bye!